Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to do a reading for Scorpio, which is going to be from 15th to 30th of April. Before starting, do subscribe and follow me on Instagram for more updates. For personal readings, contact me on Instagram or WhatsApp me. Details are given below. Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus signs in Scorpio. This is going to be a general reading. Take whatever resonates, leave what does not. So let us see what are the messages for you. By the way, I'm also a Scorpio sun. Dealing with an Aries person, okay, older person, kind of a dominating person this is, all right, my way or highway kind of a person. I do see like someone is opening up their heart to you. Oh my god, do you see this? I had my eye on this, like the first thing that I focused on was this. So I feel like this person is seeing you like a wish fulfillment. They feel like you're the one for them. You know, I feel like this is someone from the past, okay? Need not be, but I feel like out of those so many fishes floating in the sea, they have their eyes on you. They find you the most special, the most beautiful, or the most handsome, okay? Whatever you want it to be called. Person could be a Scorpio, Pisces, Cancer as well. This is someone who's connecting with you through workplace. If this is not an Aries person, could be any sign, by the way, they have this energy in them. Maybe moon, maybe rising, could be any other sign in Aries, but I see they have a strong personality traits of an Aries person. Dominating, who doesn't like to listen to no, but not in a bad way though. Okay, this person is keeping an eye on you, is watching you. There's someone who is maybe an older person or maybe at a higher position than you in your job, in your workplace. Maybe you guys are connected through work. So this person misses you, and I feel like they are thinking of making efforts towards reaching out to you. Why do I sense this is someone from the past? Okay, this is not over yet for this person, I feel. So with a lot of green here, I feel this person is opening up their heart to you. And with that blue there, I feel this person is just building up more confidence with the yellow and blue combo. This person is just gaining more confidence to speak to you. Okay, they're trying hard. And I feel like right now you're acting or you're appearing as someone who's hard to get or hard to reach out. So you're making things difficult for this person. I feel like this person is enjoying the chase here. Okay, so basically they're going against the current. You see, like the fishes are going in the to the right and this person is going to the left. Even this is a mermaid, right? He or she, they are also swimming. They're floating towards the front and all the fishes going right. So this is going against the current. I feel like this person is gonna make the effort. You're pushing them away and they're coming towards you. The more you're going to push this person away, the more they're going to reach out to you. So it's going to be the signs involved here. Ooh, see, I told you with the Six of Cups, it's very clear. This is a reconciliation, okay? Let me just pull the Love Oracle cards. This person cares for you, okay? You are someone who's a little bit a younger energy than them, okay? This person feels like they want to protect you. They want to take care of you. And I feel like, see, so many fishes here, so many fishes there. This person has options. They are not devoid of options. They have many options. But the point is that this person feels connected with you. Their heart feels connected with you. With the blue here, this person does want to reach out to you with communication. It's just that they're trying to build up that courage. Maybe because you're completely rejecting this person right now. I feel like this person wants to take you out on a coffee, or they might message you asking you to go on a coffee date with this person. Yeah, that's what I see like here. Coffee or tea. Yes, this person is not able to function without you. Maybe they're dependent on you. Maybe they miss your presence in their life, like how you made them feel in the past. Now, simply when you're not being there, this person feels empty. This person feels like there's no one special around. They really miss your vibe. This person misses your vibe. Like they're addicted to you, okay? Not in a bad way. Even though I feel like this person comes with some red flags, okay? They have some red flags. Maybe they're married. Maybe they are involved with someone, maybe they have addictions, other addictions of drugs, alcohol, or maybe there is a difference between you guys. They are from a different background, you are from a different background, there's a big age difference. So the angels are letting you know that if you're trying to free yourself from this person due to any reason it may be, you should, okay? Because I don't think, even if they want you, you should stick around if you feel like there's something that's blocking this connection. So you're doing your work, you're trying to free yourself from them. You're focused on your money, and I feel like getting involved with this person will affect your finances, will affect your career, and you're bothered. So I feel like you want to focus on your career, whereas this person is simply focusing on you. There's a lot of passion here. This person has a huge drive for you, okay? Huge drive. So I feel like this person cannot control that, and they miss your presence. They always want to give you the helping hand, and they see you as the one. They feel like you're the one for them. Okay, even though they say that they cannot marry you, or they may not be saying it, they're keeping to themselves because this is an emperor energy. I feel this person is very fatherly or very motherly or very caring towards you. And at the same time, this person is holding on the true words that they needed, that you wanted this person to speak up. They feel like you're the one for them, but they won't speak up because community doesn't allow. Yeah. Scorpions, okay, so you have options, Scorpio. You're simply enjoying, you're open to options, and you're like, okay, if this person is not focused on me, I can move on and find out someone who can give me that loyalty. Okay, you're okay with it, and you're moving on, and you're just trying to look for fun, enjoyment. You just want to love yourself, and I feel like you're also making money. And you feel rejected, or you may have gotten bored of this person, or you may be rejecting this person. Maybe because they did something that was hurting you. Maybe they started juggling you in between. So you thought of just letting this person go. And I feel like despite of all of that, you're still okay with being alone, with being single, with being without this person. You want to move on. Some of you are dealing with a Leo. Okay, so you feel like your love or your care or your you were taken for granted. This person took you for granted in the past, and you're not liking it, so you decided to leave. However, I feel this person will try to reach out to you to improve the situation. So they will try to improve the relationship between you guys, and this is gonna happen in the next few weeks. Okay, so there's a lot of blue, green, yellow, if you believe. So now it totally depends upon you if you really want to bring them back into your life, because the key is in your hand, the ball is in your court. You decide what you want, okay? If you want this person to be back, or if you want to move on. I feel like now you've decided that you want change. You don't want this person, you don't want the same energy, you don't want those, you don't want to deal with those same old patterns. You want to change, you want something new, you want something exciting, you want different. You're looking for major loyalty, and it's not bringing you that. So you may speak up. You may say that, no, this is not what I want. I'm done with your BS. I'm like, every time you are the one who has to compromise, you have to let this person go, or you have to forgive them. You know, you're done with it, and I feel like you may tell them to leave you alone, or you just want to part ways because you want to evolve, okay? So I feel like you want evolution. So you want to move away. Because so that you can grow, you can evolve, you want something new. You're done with it. And I feel like right now you're fully charged to find a new person, new energy, new situationships in life, okay, which can help you grow. And I feel like you're really started loving yourself, your femininity or your masculinity. You were very tied up, okay. You feel like this person was controlling you a lot, or the... just a mere thinking of this person was making you feel frustrated and tied up. Some of you are 23 here. So you're just done with it. You want to run away, okay? Because you've been heartbroken recently and you cannot deal with this. So you want to be done with it. You just want to move on. And you're just like, okay, I cannot let my heart get broken time and again. I just want to be set free. You just want to be free. You want to change. You're done with this. Okay, so you don't want to invest your time and your emotions in here. You have been recently very heartbroken. Scorpions are like that. It's because we people are very closed off, or we people don't like to discuss about our feelings. And it takes a lot of times for us to open up and speak the truth and understand our own feelings as well. So by that time, the other person gets frustrated and leaves the situation. Okay, so this person will reach out to you. Okay, this person will try and talk to you, and with all those sweet words that they'll try to lure you to come back into their life. They want a relationship. This person definitely wants a relationship, and they'll ask you for that. They want commitment. Yes, they're coming back, and this person wants commitment. Scorpio, Pisces, Cancer, right now they're observing if you're missing them, or if you're like, they just want to know how you're dealing with your life being single, okay, or being away from this person. However, they feel, they're sensing that you're vibrant, you're energetic, you're happy to move on, and you're feeling more free rather than before. You're much more free, okay? And this person is daydreaming a lot about you. They're wondering what's going on in your life, and they're trying to manifest you, maybe doing spells, maybe doing some manifestation tricks, okay, to really get you in their life. Although many of them, they do not work, but I tell you one easy, simple manifestation trick is that think of a thought, what you want, in a present tense for about at least 1 minute through and or beyond 1 minute. And think of that thought consistently with the emotion, with the feeling, and you'll get it manifested. Do it and see the result. All other tricks are available on my Instagram if you want to watch out more. By the way, I've just uploaded horoscopes for April on my Instagram. Go and check it out if you're interested. Heart's desire, creative expression. I feel like most of you Scorpions are getting involved in following your dreams, okay, doing something different from what other people do. Something that's related to creativity or arts, okay, yoga. I also feel like yoga is going to keep you going and really help you unblock your chakras and make you feel content within you. So I feel like your angels are already talking to you. So stay connected with your angels. Ask for guidance from time to time. I see you seeing a lot of 333 these days. So you're a manifester right now. You're in an energy to manifest things, you know. So whatever you think, however you think, okay, just observe your thoughts, okay. Your thoughts are going to turn into reality, okay. Make sure your thoughts are wonderful and powerful and positive. So they're going to turn into reality. Alright, so that's about it, Scorpions. I hope you've enjoyed it. Do like, subscribe, share, hit the bell, and comment down below. Till we see you next time. Bye, stay safe.